Guys know our if you are stuck around this channel, basically all we do on this channel is we go look for home decor every single week. So if you want to be a part of that, then subscribe.
What's up, everybody?
Welcome back.
Welcome back to another video.
We're in California today, and we're doing what we do best, which is antique shopping, home decor shopping.
Yeah.
All our favorite things for interiors.
We were going to do a San Francisco vlog, but we were like, let's just have some fun with the family, kind of take it easy.
Yeah.
And we were also like, let's do more of a specific video that's focused on something we're actually really passionate about.
Totally. For all you like diehard interior freaks, because I know so many of you are just like us. So this is for you. Hope you guys love it. So we're just going to bring you along like one of our normal days, and we're so excited to go furniture shopping in a different location because everywhere you go is something so different.
Yeah, we're
you get so much inspiration.
Like decor and furniture shopping, but we'll probably put a primary focus on antiques and vintage stores.
Yeah,
we might go into a couple of designer firms and stuff like that, but
yeah,
well, going to some of our favorites. We're up in Petaluma,
which is where I grew up.
Yeah, we were gonna start this video, we actually planned on starting it. We did start it a couple days ago in San Francisco, like in downtown, but we just got really sidetracked and didn't end up going to that many stores, and so we were like, let's just scratch this and let's start fresh.
We're
up in Petaluma, going to some,
which
one of my favorite antique shops for real.
Yes, it's
is
so good.
Siena in Petaluma.
And also the San Francisco antiques were not that strong. I was actually kind of disappointed.
Well, because the
or home decor.
It's because just the commercial retail space, it's so like expensive there and so small. You walk in and it's like a tight little room and there's not much to choose from.
Yeah, there's really not much, unfortunately.
And so, the prices are like so freaking high there.
Totally.
We need like masks. the one we went to, it was all the stuff was like really, really old and antique.
Yeah.
So the prices were like kind of ridiculous. So we were like, let's just scratch
that
this.
That box was so cool though.
It was cool.
So cool. Yeah. Just gonna go vintage shopping basically.
Yeah.
And it's in my hometown where we grew up. So
let's have some
let's
fun.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. All right, we're in the front window area.
Already looking gorgeous.
Three floors. Let's go to all three floors.
So good.
Yeah, so good.
Masks up. We're in California, bitch.
Really, really pretty. Gorgeous table.
Beautiful.
It's kind of too orange for our liking,
yeah,
but
a little bit
warm. Be a nice bar for the downstairs.
Look, I would love this antique.
That'd be kind of cool in the
downstairs
in the speakeasy.
Totally.
And it's an original by a French artist, which is kind of cool.
So cool. It's.
I mean, clown isn't really our thing.
But it works.
But it works
because it's French.
And the frame is pretty sweet too.
That's sick.
It's really cool.
I mean, it's nice.
Zabata.
This is insane. Look at this hutch at the bottom. So pretty. Absolutely beautiful. I don't have anywhere to put a hutch. Hunter, this would have been good in my office in the back. You remember? I was looking for something like this.
From the staircase, we have that one dark entryway table kind of with the two mirrors on it.
Yes.
Could something like that go there instead?
And totally, something taller.
And then you can do a bench in the front because it's not competing with each other.
I know, that table's kind of boring, isn't it? Well, and it's just like, eh. We could do better.
Or you keep that table there, and then where the bench is, do like a thinner version of that.
Totally. We need to measure that wall. I think we have the measurements. This is gorgeous for an island.
The downstairs basement bar.
Too big. It's too big.
Is it?
Oh, yeah, it's way too big.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is.
I don't think so.
Yes, it is.
I think it's perfect.
This is insane. Obsessed. This farm table. Look how tall, I mean, sorry, how long it is with the little benches. So flipping cute. Oh, just like in a bit beautiful big house. Amazing. Gorgeous. We have so much pine though. We cannot do any more pine. With these knobs, we have so much of it.
So nice.
It's really nice though.
It's like a guest bedroom as a dresser.
Those are cool. Look at these woven chairs. Very Nashville, isn't it? I mean, okay. Gorgeous word. God, it's so nice to be around good antiques. It's lovely, darling. My camera skills are really bad, and I know you're gonna yell at me for all this footage.
You're so bad at carrying the camera around.
This photo. That reminds me of like Marin Headlands. Like if I were to look at that, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think if you're gonna get a home inspired piece of art,
Yeah.
I think you gotta get like rolling hills. Like Petaluma-ish.
Like Petaluma? Okay, yeah. Fair enough. But I remember all of it. Like, I mean, Bodega Bay. It's
sure,
like,
I want you to get something that speaks to you.
Totally.
But I also think if you're going to get one inspired pick,
get the Rolling Hills.
Okay. That's just my opinion, but okay. You do you, homie. Where's Albert?
These are fun arts. Look at that.
Oh, with his dog?
Look at this dog, and he's painting. Hunter.
Mm-hmm. That's cool.
That's you.
Me and Buckeye.
Are you kidding me? Oh, how gorgeous. Wow, this is like, I think, really authentic stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's Buckeye. It's like moving when you look at it. You feel something, and that's what I love about art. People think I'm crazy when I talk about art. They're like, oh, just let Juge do her crazy art talk. But it's like, I think if you actually are interested in art, then you understand the vibe. But you're supposed to feel things when you look at it.
That's like, really pretty colors. Those horses, the bottom one.
Gorgeous. I feel like you have a lot of like this though. You need to get away from that.
No.
Just mix in some.
Okay,
things.
Mask on, please, ma'am.
I think this could be a really good desk for my office, but it's pine. Maybe I could switch out the hardware. Beautiful wood. I want like a rustic desk like this. I don't know. I've had the hardest time with a desk. Oh my god, but the hardest things to find. I don't know why. These chairs are insane. Beautiful. So beautiful. Oh, they're sold.
This bar.
That's cute too.
This bar could be great from the Champagne region.
So cool. Super cool. Love.
You'd cut it perfect in that spot.
It really would. It's perfect size.
Mm-hmm.
Mm, good antiques here. Okay. For our bedroom, we were thinking the lamps are wrong. You want to change them. We're thinking glass would be amazing. What do you think? I think it kind of, the wood is like this vibe.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean? And this piece is amazing.
We've been talking glass, so I mean, this would make sense.
Totally. And like with the little alternates, it's so cute. I think you can make traditional pieces feel super modern with the right stuff on it, like the right books and decor, don't you think?
All I'm looking at is that right there.
The boat? Of course you are. Oh, man. Should we get this for a buckle? Alright, we're just gonna take a bathroom break. We're saying how people in California are just much different than people in Nashville. They're not as easygoing, not as friendly. Everything's a hassle. We're so impatient. We're like, okay, I'm so sorry. I even asked for anything. Jeez. Might be our own sensitivity, but we just are like, try to be nice to people when we interact with them, but they're really so cool. Rude here.
In my office, on the doors on the inside?
Yeah. Sure.
Like, changing, like adding some kind of like more
something
French Revolution
element.
Style element.
For
to
sure.
It.
No, I do really like that. If you can find, you do it from the outside. Are the French doors even have that? The
from the inside.
Oh. Get those too.
But I would have to do more of a handle as well, oh. Like this. I mean, not this one, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, that'd be sweet. We can make it work. I need some, they have really good stuff. It's just so nice to go somewhere else than all the stores we always see in Nashville. There's like not much, but we should go up to Kentucky, hon, and like look at stuff. Don't you agree? Okay, cool. Good talk. Yeah, no, I totally agree. Yep, for sure. Yep. Got it. Oh boy. Okay. Anything. Sorry, let me switch you to this view. You don't want to look at me. Sorry, you kind of forget to do that when you're. I bet my footage is all shaky. Someone's looking at
me. Very Egyptian.
This is love.
Careful.
So good. Not for my desk chair.
Mm-mm.
Too farmy.
Too old.
Too old. Yeah, good call.
I used to come here in my free time and just like roam. Anytime Julie had like an appointment or something down here, this is where I would spend like hours just like taking my sweet time.
I mean, it's amazing. Ooh, this is cool. Show them this. How pretty is that wallpaper? It's a French hand stenciled wallpaper. Ugh. That, like, I would love to find vintage wallpaper in Paris, like for the bathroom. How cool would that be?
It's cool.
I think this could be really cool. It could really set the mood for the gallery wall.
Mm-hmm.
In my office.
Totally.
When I say mood, I mean how it's going to be styled. How it's not going to be just like a perfect, like, symmetrical gallery wall.
Totally.
But like, some are going to be like tall, and some are going to be long and horizontal, and some are going to be square.
Yeah, it's like a different shape.
And so it's a different shape, and it, because it's a mirror, and it's not necessarily
like an art piece, but it's still decor.
And it's still artistic.
Yeah, I love it. I think you do it. Feels a little, it feels a little bit, is it from England?
It's German.
It's German. Yeah, it feels a little uptight to me. Like, it's a little bit, like, it was, like, maybe in the army, or that makes sense that it's German. It feels a little bit polished to me, for your taste.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
Oh, for sure.
Or do you like that about it? Because everything you have is kind of rustic. Like, you like the contrast.
Well, because the room color is, like, a matte.
Yeah.
I don't know if I want, like, a matte, unfinished mirror.
Totally.
Clear mirror, I think.
Yeah, it's, like, very Titanic feeling.
Yes.
Yes.
Which is kind of the vibe that's going to go on in there. Kind of the rhythm.
It is, definitely,
like
definitely.
The crest and the ageness of it.
Yeah, absolutely. It's just a little bit like buttoned up to me. That's the best way I can put it. Like preppy almost. Do you know what I'm saying?
It won't be preppy though.
Okay. If you don't, if you're, that's just, if you're asking my true thoughts, that's what I wanted to say about it. But if you love it, then you know the vibe. It's your vision. I don't want to ever take that over. That's your place, you know?
It's also like $750, which I don't think is worth it.
Yeah. Why don't you walk around, see if you're thinking about it. If you're thinking about it, you know you really love it. That's my tip when antiquing. I always tell people, if you think you found a piece that you really like, but you're just like not quite sure, I would walk around, keep going, and if you keep thinking about it, then you know it's like really connecting to you and it, like, you feel special about it. But if you're not really thinking about it, you probably don't care about it that much or didn't feel that attached to it if it didn't make that much of an impact on you. So that's kind of how I judge if it's the right thing or not, because I get super excited and I want to like get everything.
Yeah,
so.
I've already forgot about the mirror already.
You did? So. Okay. Okay, so then fair enough. For real.
Oh, hey, buddy.
I love gold things. I'm very drawn to gold things. Have you noticed this? A brass shell. I always like sea-inspired things. I don't know if it's because I grew up near the water. But like, my mom always liked shells, and I don't know, I just like them. But in more modern materials, I guess. This is cool. Do you like it?
I feel like it's one of those things you would have just temporarily and then like get over quick.
You do?
Not as timeless, Julia, as...
Okay.
I would like to see.
More impulsive.
Uh-huh.
Sure, I see that. I like a mix of, it's kind of my style though. I like to wear, I think like your interior style kind of shows your clothing style too. Like I like to wear plain things with like a pop of something eclectic. Mm-hmm. And I think that's how I like to decorate as well. So I like eclectic things. Just a hint of them.
A little quick promo.
No, I didn't mean to do that, but.
You liking this right here?
Look at these garment, old garment covers. Antique garment bag. Oh my god. I should get this to put my wedding dress in.
That's
cool. How cool would that be?
Mm-hmm.
Or to give as a wedding gift. Oh my god. For the bride. Be like, this is what you can store your dress in after. And keep it forever. That's so cute.
Not every person would appreciate that as much as you would.
I know. True. True. But it's a cool ass thing to have.
Super cool. Okay. I'm really liking these for the bourbon room. They're old pictures from Vanity Fair. Freaking cool. These are all such a vibe.
I have a really good idea. I need to put textiles in my, I need a hutch with full vintage textiles.
You can't see them.
But babe, I'll put them out like this. It's like, it's me. I love fabrics.
It'd be cool to have a stack like that on your,
Cheers.
No, on the dresser thing in your office. Like, instead of like coffee table books, it's like a stack of
books. I just want it to be everything that I love.
Mm-hmm.
So like any object.
Careful, babe. That chair's about to fall.
Okay. Ribbons. I mean, are you kidding me? Look at this. Antique American floral. How cool is that? Okay, I think it's a little curtain. Look at this. That's a curtain, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Are they too dollhouse-ish?
No.
I don't think so either. They're kind of earthy, right?
Mm-hmm.
We could do them like just over that little...
What's that one called? What is that?
It's a pin. A safety pin.
Oh.
I think they're probably... They don't make them in long lengths.
Or we could layer them in our bedroom above the windows, above our nightstands.
Yeah.
Like layer them behind the drapes.
Like as Roman shades. Mm-hmm. Use the fabric as Roman shades.
Yeah.
That'd be sweet. Do you think that's the right fabric for it? Will it look super traditional?
I think it's cool as That's my color and it's yours.
Right?
It's cool. It's us. It's badass. I like it.
Okay, well, how many panels would we?
Just get all those. Get that whole stack.
I love those red ones. Really?
Yeah, why not? We'll find something
cool. They're made in America, which is pretty incredible.
How much are they?
I don't know. Oh, 125 each.
That's pretty high.
Okay. That's worth it.
Hello.
We just have to make sure that they're the right. We would at least need two panels on each side, don't you think? Those are skinny.
Yeah, buy that stack.
I think we probably just need four, don't you?
I don't know. Just buy all five. It's a backup.
We need all this? Because we won't need to do uneven numbers. We would only do even numbers. Okay, we'll get them.
All right, we're loving this lace frame, or this lace piece with a wood frame. That I could be really good in the stairwell. What do you think, babe?
I really like it. I worry that I wish it had a little bit more of a solid frame on it. Like, I just don't want it to pull too old. I don't want it to age the room too much. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because it could definitely do that. But I do love, like, the fabric is, like, amazing. It's so us. Like, the style, the stitching, and everything.
This could even be sitting on your dresser piece.
That's what I was
leaned thinking. Up against the wall.
But I kind of like that checkered when I found the city. It's, like, more cool.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Against an old piece. Yeah,
I'm trying to think we got, or like when you first get up the stairs. Like yes. Right when you first get all the way to
it
the top.
It can't rest on an antique piece or it's going to age it. So
right.
It has to go on a modern surface.
Mm-hmm.
I think for our style, it could just make it a little too traditional.
It's kind of Victorian.
Kind of Victorian, exactly. That's what I mean when I say age.
It'd be cool if it was one of these that was like a goose.
Oh, I know.
If I put one of these animal ones in my office.
Totally.
And I love this quilt. This is really pretty. A American Hawaiian quilt. Oh, it's quite expensive, but it is beautiful. I just love the pattern on it. It's really cool. Got so many amazing fabrics. Especially here. A lot of curtains are so pretty. I love the material. I feel like I would want to make this into like an overshirt and like wear it over a bandeau. It'd be so cute. What a vibe is this couch. Shit. Hunter needs this for his bourbon room. Hunter.
Yeah.
She found the coolest couch for your bourbon room. That's so good, right?
That's so cool.
It's like perfect for you. What if we find... It might be a little bit big is the only thing.
Look at this tall.
Right. That's what I'm saying. For that room, it could be a little bit big. But what if you get chairs that are like... this vibe. It's in like beautiful condition. It's amazing. It would take the whole room though. It kind of almost be more of like a room statement. Yeah, it's the fabric. It's the fabric, of course. Amazing. Yeah, it's freaking sweet. This is like a bourbon sofa. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, it is a vibe. Like, yes. Serve me up. You know what I mean? Ooh. For my office?
Hey, those fencing helmets over there is kind of a rough looking vibe.
100%. 100%.
That brown is cool as
cool, right? It might be a little too vintage.
That thing's cool.
Julia's office.
I don't think this is the one.
That's cool though. I like it. I like it against the pink actually, it looks nice.
It does look good against pink. Brown and pink is a great color combination. Always.
What are you playing with over here?
I'm playing with these cubes that have words on them. I like them, I don't know why. I'm drawn to them. A memory about a plan for. Is it like conversation starters, kind of? I'm gonna ask, bringing it down.
It is kind of cool, it's creative.
I love it.
I think you're supposed to get like a couple different die and then you roll it and create a sentence.
Maybe, that's a good idea.
It's kind of cool.
The other one in a little bag. It's way too hard to explain, but it's all wrapped up. And Hunter's grabbing a bracelet that he found. It was really cool. But I'm in a new antique store and this book is incredible. Silver lined. It says in Italy. Well, off Benny in Italy. So cool. $28. I just think it's so pretty. Look at the silver. I mean, how sick. I really like that. Super, super cool. In Vogue? Oh, yes, sir. Oh, my God. Oh. See, this is the stuff you come for. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. I'm dead. Oh, my God. I gotta get this. $25. Oh, my God. So excited. I am dead. I have been wanting a textile book so bad. Oh, it's in black and white. Okay, I was kind of wanting like to look at actual fabrics, but these are only black and white. But that's okay. Wow. Insane. So cool. I love stuff like this. I can totally see Hunter doing something like that in his like office with paintbrushes or some shit. It's kind of cute, the cook sign. Trying not to be shaky, it is so hard though. There's like a little American section. Maybe not. Ooh, I may, oh, that's incredible. Oh, that's so sick. Oh my God, I'm in our freaking Hunter.
It's a lot of personality.
Oh my God, for your bourbon room? Are you kidding me? It's insane. I mean, that would take it to the next level.
I know, I love it. It created a nice mood.
Oh my God.
It's pretty dim.
Hunter, look.
Of course.
It's real marble, that's why. And it is very expensive. Oh my God, it's so insane. Fudge, that's good. Okay, we also are so obsessed with this. I've been looking for a San Francisco painting and
okay, I found one that's pretty cool.
It's so pretty, but this is a little green. I actually like green right now though. It's like a vibe, but it's kind
of
trendy.
The last store, I took a picture of a piece of art. It's this.
Oh, I saw that too and I noticed
San
it.
San Francisco.
It is?
Intercontinental.
I really liked that.
In San Francisco.
I really liked that. Really nice. But I do really want one of the bridge, like so badly. Arg. Just hard to find. I keep seeing these boxes everywhere and I'm obsessed with them. This one. Oh, wow. Carved chest over 600 carved notches circa 1880. Oh, this price is way better. Some of the other ones were like 1200 in the city. This is way cheaper. But it looks newer. I don't want it to be like a try hard. I love this for my office though. This shit. This looks kind of like our nightstands. It's the exact same shape. I think it's French. We got ours at Round Top. French farm table with simple lines and single drawer tray with chop and legs with chestnut sides. This is exactly the model of our nightstands. We got ours for half the price of that. Not that the price matters, I don't think you should be so caught up on pricing when you're looking at things. I know you want to stay within a budget, but it's like, if it's worth it to you or not, you'll invest the money. Does that make sense? So that's why it's just like, I'm not gonna go around and like price shit out for you guys. Like, sorry, it's just not the vibe. It ruins the creativity. It's just supposed to be fun. So I'm sorry, I'm just being honest. If you're offended by that, then you can work through that and get over it. But that's just my honest thoughts. So if I point it out, I point it out. If not, I'm sorry. It's just not what it's about. But anyways, that's pretty. Really nice solid wood. But and it's a bigger one, so I would say that's worth it. And that makes sense. Ooh, we've been looking for a little lamp for our friend. Oh my gosh. He's a trumpet player and he's doing a bourbon room or a studio right now / bourbon room. This will be so cool in his office. All right, Hunter just found these vintage dress boots.
They're 1940s.
They're so cool.
I thought this would be really cool. One, just to wear in general, but also for your party.
It's kind of like a old theme, like roaring 20s, but even as the 40s, but how good do they look on Hunter? They're so sick. And I could so see you styling those like in more outfits than one. They're so like your shape of shoe, wouldn't you agree? Mm-hmm. Like narrow.
They're the same as the ones I have on.
You might like older shoes because the silhouettes are more narrow. You should look into that actually. Cool. They're sick, I love them. You've gotta get those and they fit perfect. What are the chances? I love them. I was just telling my mom that I am obsessed with beads that are, you know, from different countries. And these are amazing. They're terracotta beads. I already have some terracotta beads. These are really cool though. These are ancient trading beads. Yeah, they're $600. They're gorgeous, but you can tell they're really, really incredible. Each one is like individual. I'd put this in like a, you know, like an adobe house, or if you live in Southern California and it was more like desert or like, natural organic. I wouldn't do it so much in our house in Tennessee in the South, because I feel like we're going for a more traditional vibe there. But like in a Palm Springs or like, do you know what I'm saying? All the girls in Southern California, their style's more natural. I think it's pretty. I love this artwork. Like for the hall bath, I feel like I'd be sick. You know what I mean? Like Paris vibes, dark.
It's hand-drawn and painted poster for a sculptor.
Okay.
In jewelry exhibit in Paris, 1964.
Wow. Oh, look, here's all the information. Okay, so it's pretty cool.
I like the writing.
I do too. I love it. Okay. Can you take this for a little bit? Should we get it for Dad?
That's cool. That's, yeah, we gotta get that for your dad. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's broken, but we'll fix it. I was just saying how expensive beads are. That these are really cool, the gold with the bone.
Mm-hmm.
They're really pretty. I'm gonna start collecting beads. I'm obsessed with beads and fabric.
I did think a really cool thing for my office is to have a rope. I saw one at the last shop. I was like, that'd be kind of a cool thing to add.
Absolutely.
To the gallery or whatever.
I concur. Hunter and I could not figure out what these are, but they're stamps, like hand-carved stamps. French stamps for like a printing press.
Mm-hmm. They're one of the last. It says...
freaking cool.
Used in one of the last silk hand printing companies in France. They're really unique.
They're so unique. I mean, I feel like that's a really cool way if you like want a natural element in your house somewhere, like that vibe is very in right now, to incorporate this, like a wall of these.
You could do like a couple, like a stack of three, you know?
It's very like organic feeling, but it's French, so it's a cool mix.
I like that one.
Yeah, I like this one. I like this group,
mm-hmm.
But you could customize them. Where can we put them?
They're cool.
them? We'll think about it. We got it. If we're thinking about it, we'll have.
That's pretty.
That is pretty, like a shield.
Roman battle, cool team shield antique. It's a good color. I thought this is a really cool idea for my office. Is like a stationary thing like this on the shelf. This is an old fly fishing rod.
Oh, cool.
It was from the 1930s, but it's kind of cool that it's in the case. And having that like as a display somewhere is kind of cool.
For sure. Super cool.
I don't know. I was really drawn to this art piece though, too.
Yeah, I like that too. I
couldn't figure out what it is, but it's just a painting.
Looks like horse like thingies. Do you know what I mean? Like maybe a jockey would hold it, or like a horse whip?
I don't know. I also thought these were kind of cool.
Cute.
To have something like this, the, one of these geese in my office somewhere up top.
He's so cute.
I saw that earlier.
Japanese. Oh god, I bet they have the most incredible.
Did you see this one back here? This one was really cool. I thought you would like this. I feel like that is so cool above a bed. Tapestry framed already. It's just like a nice color palette.
I have that vibe to the vintage rugs on the ground, so I feel like it competes.
Yeah.
But if you have like a super modern house that you can't put a vintage rug down, it's already carpeted, that's really cool because it brings in that element. You know what I'm saying?
It came to me, it's very amber interiors.
Very.
Like the color of the backing, the mat behind it.
No, totally. The frame job is really cool. It's like a vintage frame. Could that go in your bourbon room? Where can we put that?
It's really unique. I feel like it's
I like how dark it is. You know what? I feel like that would ground the upstairs bedroom.
I know. I was thinking about that above the bed in there or something. Or like on a wall.
It really needs something like that.
I feel like, I don't know.
Oh, it's not that, Hunter.
I really like the
$750
way it's framed.
Art.
It's
That's
nice.
So good.
And it's big.
Totally. Like, impactful. You need that. I don't know. Is it too tribal feeling?
And when I first walked through, it felt tribal, but I think it's because of everything else that's on the table.
Totally.
But that by itself is such a cool thing.
Absolutely, I couldn't agree more.
And it could be good above a bed. It could be good when you first walk into our house on that wall right on the right.
Totally.
Kind of sets the tone, is like, you know what I mean?
Should we see if they can ship it?
Yeah, they can.
Okay.
But we'll talk to them about it.
Grab the tag?
Yeah, here.
Okay.
Is there anything else you want?
I kind of liked that chair, but it's a little intricate for me.
Which one?
That one, the wooden one. I like the shape of it, but it's a little bit too patterned.
I like the Wii on the wall.
The Wii is so cute. I love it.
A Wii.
All
right, I think we're gonna check out and move on to the next store. All right, we're at a new place.
How do you keep their nursery? They're getting blue also.
That is cute.
These are so cute.
They're
all hand-painted. What are these?
Handkerchiefs?
They're so cute. I love them. Gosh, babe, can you imagine?
I know.
What we would do in Europe, antiquing. We would flip.
Well, we would definitely have a crate and load that.
We could spend weeks going through antique shops.
I know.
Weeks.
I know. But you'd have to go into it knowing, like, hey, we have a crate set up. You know what I hate about antique shopping?
What?
Especially when you're not at home, is figuring out the logistics of getting it there.
Absolutely.
Even after like Round Top, it's like, it's such a hassle.
It's like, someone just figure it out for me, please.
In Europe, there's a language barrier, and you're trying to figure out how can I get this piece to the right
crate
without me having to be there to put it in that crate.
Totally.
You know?
It's a nightmare.
It's a nightmare.
Can we figure out a hack for that?
Yeah. That's pretty. That'd be really pretty framed. I like that a lot. It's beautiful. What are you looking at?
Looking at this house. Well, I was looking at this. Because how cool are these hangers, for one, okay? But then, this top.
That is really pretty.
But if I were to be, like, crop it, just so it was a little bit, because for me, this would be, like, a little boxy for my body type. But it's super cool.
That's really cool.
I know. But, anyways.
I like it. I see the vig.
I know.
We just got into the city, parked the car. We actually had some pastries and stuff this morning.
We did.
Delicious.
So good. We already eaten so many amazing foods.
What was it called? Jane's Bakery?
Jane's Bakery.
It's really good.
Iconic.
Yeah, it came highly recommended.
I've actually never been, but it's like famous.
We are gonna go antique shopping.
We're going antique shopping.
We're just, I guess we're going like home decor shopping.
You guys know, if you are stuck around this channel, basically all we do on this channel is we go look for home decor every single week. So if you wanna be a part of that, then subscribe.
Fun
stuff. Hunter and I are equally as addicted to furniture. Yes, him too.
Yeah.
We love furniture. Love interiors.
Love design.
Just as much as each other.
Love being able to take pieces and like transform a room.
We're obsessed.
Or see a vision and like make it come to life. We really enjoy that kind of stuff.
So we noticed we started spending all of our free time antiquing. That's all we like to, every Friday in Nashville we go. And so when we came to San Francisco, we're like, hold on, which day are we going antiquing?
Well, it's really nice because we bond over that. We're both equally passionate about it. And we genuinely like each other's ideas. So Julia will have an idea and I'm like full on board for it. Like putting together a plan to make that come to life and vice versa. Like I'll have an idea.
We work well together.
To go after something for a room or for a bathroom or for an office or whatever.
Even though we both have different styles.
We have the same style. Which is, our style is a combo of our two styles.
Exactly.
Which creates like.
Our style.
Our rhythm.
Our rhythm. Exactly.
With all that said, like we genuinely like each other's tastes and each other's style, and it kind of like we're very open to those things.
Yes.
I like her style, she likes mine. It kind of comes together to create what our style is collectively.
Exactly. Which I would say is a little European influenced, a little bit traditional, a little bit relaxed California.
I would say
a little bit farm.
The European aspect of our style comes from the antique aspect of our style.
Absolutely. Do you think it, most furniture, antique furniture, was made there? You can get American antiques, but there's more because they've been, Europe was around longer, historically.
And I like wood products, and so I'm pretty passionate
Europe
about
has
finding
good
like
wood.
Different countries made furniture different ways.
Yes.
Like the Dutch made furniture very different than people in Spain and very different than people in Asian countries. And it's cool to find certain pieces based on the style they are made in.
Yes.
Whether it's like mortise and tenon, which is usually like Dutch or Asian countries.
Is this gonna turn into an interior decor channel? I think it might.
Maybe. I don't know. We really like it a lot. I feel like
it has to. It's definitely our biggest passion. I feel like it's what y'all like the most. And it's all, slowly and slowly, that's all we really do. It's like go antiquing. And I think we might need to just do it for our job. Because we like
outside of our job and the business we're running, we spend all of our time talking about
Furniture and interiors,
literally. So
I think that's when you find what your purpose is.
Totally.
And I think we may have found it.
We're feeling really good about it.
We just love it.
And we have fun with it. And we're to the point where we no longer want to just like look at pieces. Like as you've seen in Nashville, we've been jumping on pieces and buying pieces. And now when we travel, like if we go to Europe, hopefully in the next like 6 months, we want to get a crate and buy pieces and ship pieces back and
do it all.
And so now when we're like in other states, like we buy things and we like them. We're not looking for inspo. I think we used to just really get so inspired walking through Big Daddy's and different antique shops. And now
we pull the trigger now.
Yeah.
And we're like, let's just create our collection. And we would love to get like a warehouse. We can start like, when we find good pieces, like we would honestly just love to travel the world and find antiques and sell them.
Yeah. But not even be an antique dealer.
Not a dealer. Like I just want to do it for fun.
A bunch of antiques that were curated by us based on the things that we would put in our home.
Exactly. Exactly.
You know,
we could do that. Like, you know, we could have a store where we would go find pieces. Would you guys buy it? would you want that? Let us know.
You almost have to have like an online store.
You do. And then we would go find everything and then we would post it. Just saying. Okay. Anyway, we need to go into East Nashville and start looking over there.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't done that yet.
Yeah.
We got to get in the nitty gritty.
I want to go to like up to Kentucky.
Oh,
and like, I
want to
go to like, I want to get away from the city. You got to get to like the outskirts.
The outskirts. Couldn't agree more.
I want to go to like Alabama.
Yeah.
Atlanta.
Atlanta has bomb ass stuff. We got to go to Atlanta.
It's time to make some moves.
You know, we should go to Atlanta and look for pieces before Christmas. Okay. Let's go.
Let's go. What are we waiting for?
We need stuff.
We're really excited with the way things are going with our house. We've said that before. a lot of really fun ideas that are kind of coming together that are going to be taking place.
Mm-hmm.
Some renovation projects are going to be taking place in 2022.
Yeah.
2022 is the year of our house and of projects and of dreams.
Well, you know what
dreams are made of.
Totally. And you know what's cool is that if we started decorating
Lizzie McGuire said it best.
She did say this it best. What dreams this are is made why of. I'm married to you. Okay. Thank you. Respect that so much.
I'm ready.
And break.
Oh, wait. Oh. I have it going down. Ready and break.
Oh.
That's a pretty cool boat. Mm-hmm. Talia's liking that piece.
Obsessed. It's Italian walnut. 18th century.
It's cool.
How cool is
that? It's really pretty.
I love the carving.
I know.
For the shelves.
I know. Here's another boat.
Oh my god, here's another box. Pretty. Jacobian restored Bible document box from 17th century English oak. Wow. That's insane.
It's a cool lamp.
Powder caddy. Like gunpowder?
I might have a pot.
I'm all into textiles. They're like my new thing. And finding vintage ones, they're like, look at the pattern. And this on a bed is like done.
I'm looking for a San Francisco piece of art. That's so unique.
What I'm realizing about design is that you have to go looking for the pieces and they come across you. Like, it just happens. It's not, you can't force interiors.
No.
And you can't pre-plan a whole room because you might be like, I found this dish and this is the inspiration for the whole bedroom. So what color bed am I going to do?
Mm-hmm.
What linens am I going to get?
And plan around it.
Yeah, but you can't, like, unless you come out and see that, it's not going to happen.
How cool would that look once my office is painted black, that clock?
Totally. Love it. Okay. This, I think, is so cute. Look, these are like horse bits, but look at this little heart on these little chain. And they're like dangled off of a door handle or like an armoire. Gorgeous. So cool. I love that. Okay, we're looking at this box that we really like. Yeah, it's like definitely, you can see how old it is, you know? I'm saying, you can just see. What do you think? It's very delicate. That's for sure. I mean, I might be worried that it wouldn't make its way back.
Just came across this flower pot vase thing. You can tell it's like super old and it looks like almost like a wine barrel made the same way, but it's smaller and thinner, more like oval. It's really cool. She probably won't let me get another bucket though. Mm-hmm. I have too many buckets.
All right, we're stopping in Hudson Grace. It's one of our favorite stores. It's actually started in the Bay Area and it got acquired by Crate & Barrel. So you can find all their stuff on their website, I'm pretty sure. Not all of it, but some of it. Anyways, these baskets are incredible. So gorgeous. And we found a few things that I'm gonna show you. We've got a doggy bowl, so we approve of that. We actually are getting this vase, which is so cool. Super long and has different glass things in it, which is thought for the entryway would be perfect. These are so pretty too. They're very expensive, but they're really nice. They've got beautiful candle selection. So many cool books, really good books. And beautiful handmade wood bowls. Blown glasses. This is where our dishes are from. So we have these mugs and these bowls, these plates. This is the collection we have. We always get questions on these, and here they are. Love those.
All right, y'all. We are back at home.
Yep.
In San Francisco.
And hope you guys enjoyed that video. We just kind of ended up piecing together every single shop that we went to during our trip. So just popped in and just took you behind the scenes.
The first day in San Francisco, that ended up being the end of the vlog. We ran into a couple of people that we knew and started getting in conversation with them. And then the battery died and it was just kind of all over the place. So we restarted the video on another day. But still wanted to include some of those clips.
Better than nothing. Hope you guys enjoyed watching like what kind of stuff is available out there and learning some shops in the area. So
we'll
do more soon.
And we're back in Nashville now and going to get back to the normal regular programming.
Yes.
Which, I mean, I feel like every vlog has something to do with like home or landscaping or just some project working
on. Our life.
But we're really excited what's to come. This is birthday week for Julia. Yep. We have a lot of fun stuff planned this week. We'll be vlogging everything. And if you're new here, subscribe, stick around. We'd love to have you. And we love you all.
Bye.